वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज धीरज कुमार साहू रिप्रेजेंटिंग द टॉपिक परफॉर्मेंस पैरामीटर ऑफ आईसी इंजन। दिस इज इन द सिलेबस ऑफ फोर्थ सेमेस्टर मैकेनिकल डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट्स इन द सब्जेक्ट थर्मल इंजीनियरिंग टू। सो लेट्स बिगिन। सो द फर्स्ट टर्म इज इंडिकेटेड पावर। इंडिकेटेड पावर इज सिंपली the power developed by the combustion of fuel. In an engine we supply a fuel, so by the combustion of fuel, fuel is burned and it will give some power. That power is known as indicated power. Okay, so indicated power can be calculated by the formula n small n into pm l a n k into 10 by 6 in the unit kilowatt, where small n is the number of cylinders, the number of cylinder used in the engine. Pm, this the second term, is the mean effective pressure that we will read further. Mean effective pressure, that will be in bar. So 1 bar is 10 to the power 5 pascal. 1 pascal is 1 newton by 1 meter square. Now this A is the area of piston in meter square, piston cylinder or piston cylinder, area of cylinder. Actually the formula is given pi by 4 d square. Okay, we will have d and we will get d square, pi by 4 d square. So this k is half for 4 stroke and 1 for 2 stroke. Okay, half for 4 stroke and 1 for 2 stroke. Now this L is the stroke length and capital N is speed in RPM. So this was indicated power. Now the second term is brake power. Brake power is the power developed by engine at the output shaft. If we compare indicated power, brake power will be less than indicated power. That means there is some losses in power while developing the power by the engine. So indicated power is always greater than brake power, and the difference between them is known as frictional power. Frictional power is the difference between indicated power and brake power, that is indicated power minus brake power, IP minus brake power. So brake power can be calculated by the formula 2 pi nt by 60. N is speed in RPM, T is the torque in Newton meter. So N is RPM, rotation per minute. Okay. So the unit of brake power will be in watt, depending upon torque is in kilonewton or newton. If it is in newton, then it will be in watt. And if it is in kilonewton per meter, kilonewton meter, then it will be in kilowatt. Now the mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency is defined as the ratio of brake power to the indicated power, the power developed by the fuel to the power developed by the engine. So brake power divided by indicated power will be mechanical efficiency, and this term will be in decimal. That means it will be a decimal value. If we multiply 100, then we will get the value in percentage. So the mechanical efficiency of the IC engine can be shown by this formula, brake power by indicated power. Now the brake power can be calculated by two different methods, or brake power can be measured by two different methods. The instrument used is dynamometer. So dynamometer is one type of, the first type is prony brake dynamometer or rope brake dynamometer. So prony brake dynamometer. In prony brake, we will have some brake load in newtons and the length of the arm from in meters. This is the length and this will be load applied, W. So this is the length. So speed is in RPM. Brake power equal to 2 pi nt by 60. 2 pi nt by 60. Now torque is W into L. As we know, torque equal to force into perpendicular distance. Now the force is W into L, so WL. Now if we supply this value T as WL, we will get the brake power in watt. Now there is another type of dynamometer, that is rope brake dynamometer. In rope brake, we will have some type of rope wounded or wrapped around a wheel. So the rope rope diameter can be taken as small d, and the brake diameter can be taken as d. If I consider the diagram, this is the drum and some kind of rope is wrapped. So if I tell how to compare it, this diameter, the total inside circle diameter is capital D, and this diameter is small d. This one is small d. So the total length will be d plus d. If we neglect this d, we will have this formula W minus S pi n d by 60 in watt. W minus S pi d plus d whole into n by 60 in watt. Now what is this S? This is the spring balance given to this instrument. There is will be a spring that will balance it. Thus the spring load is taken as S. Now the total load will be taken, since the W is moving downward and there is always a spring load that is balancing this. So the total load acting on the apparatus will be W minus S, since the direction is opposite. Spring will force, upward force, and it is in downward. So the formula for brake power will be W minus S whole into pi d plus d into n by 16 the unit watt. So thank you for watching.